3.5 years after his death, the son of an Ewa Beach couple is honored.
Not once, but many times over, for his strength, bravery, and courage. Olena Hughes shares his story.
Today, 5 years ago, at 9 o'clock in the morning on January 11, 2008, Jordan was diagnosed with the cancer that he has.
The 16-year-old high school student had cancer of the soft tissue cells.
Jordan's had spread to his lungs and his bone marrow, lymph nodes, and he was a stage four.
For 23 months, the teen fought for his life, a story well documented online and seen across the globe.
He kind of accepted what was going on, and somewhere in himself, he just kind of realized, he just kind of came to a realization that this was kind of his destiny.
For his courage, Jordan was honored with several awards created in his name, in addition to many once-in-a-lifetime opportunities.
His t-shirt flew in space with the space shuttle Atlantis, an STS-132, and did a bunch of orbits. He became an honorary astronaut.
He was also an honorary PGA member who met all the pros, traveled to Italy, and also had a sit-down one-on-one chat with former President George H.W. Bush. He died 5 days before his 18th birthday, but his legacy lives on.
He's an ambassador for St. Baldrick's, and he's the statistic that 1 in 5 children will not survive cancer.
St. Baldrick's is one of the largest child cancer research and assistance organizations in the world.
There's 5 ambassadors,
so
4 of which are still living.
Obviously, that did not survive.
Originally from Maryland, the Paganellis moved to Oahu a few years ago after Jordan's death. They remain committed to honoring their only child and currently speak, raise funds, and offer support to those affected by cancer.
It's always bittersweet for me. Of course, we wish he were here for sure.
Olena Hugh, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.